Here I am once again wondering if changing out the stock thermal solution on the Z1 Extreme inside of the ROG Ally can give us any sort of benefit at all, whether it's more performance or better cooling. I just feel like there might be a little bit more we can get out of it. Well, after my last video, there were a lot of people who left comments saying that I should test out one specific solution, and I'm gonna do that in this video along with a couple other ones. So let's get to testing.
No. Adam, what's up? What happened?
Yeah, you know what? I forgot to put one more thing back in the Steam Deck, so yeah, I gotta open it up yet again. Wow, I must be tired. Oh, let's just turn this video off now. So like I said, after my last video where I tried out a different thermal paste on the ROG Ally, I got a lot of good feedback in the comments. Thank you so much for everybody commenting in. And so I wanted to change the testing just a little bit to kind of make sure that it's a more fair test, but also wanted to try different solutions. One in particular people really kept bringing up, and it was liquid metal. And I don't know if you saw in my last video, but I'm not the best even putting on normal thermal paste, so if I tried liquid metal, I would definitely ruin it and maybe even endanger my life. So I'm not gonna try liquid metal. Instead, one of the other solutions that a lot of people said I should try was this PTM 7950, so a thermal pad solution. We're gonna try that. We're gonna try a couple different methods to see if we can get any extra performance or better cooling out of the Ally. Once again, I actually don't think that is a bad cooling solution that comes stock, but maybe there's a way to improve it. And I like messing around with things, so let's test it out. First things first, though, I need to run some benchmarks with this ROG Ally. And I will say that this is actually a different ROG Ally. I got a brand new retail unit that does have the stock thermal paste. The one I used in the last video was actually the review unit I had. I didn't want to reuse that one, so we got a retail unit, brand new thermal paste on it. So let's get to testing with the stock settings. So first up is Horizon Zero Dawn. I'm going to go into the settings, confirm that it's in 1080p with no adaptive upscaling or at all. It's set to 120 hertz and no VSync. And I have the preset on original. Let's go ahead and run the benchmark. And you can see I'm running MSI Afterburner up here in the corner. We're gonna be monitoring a couple things, mostly the power. And right now, because this is the first run that I'm doing, it's actually boosting up all the way to 37 watts right now. And I am plugged in with the charger. We're gonna see the utilization, but then also the temperature on that GPU. So after that first run, we got an average FPS of 38, but I was watching the power, and we are in turbo mode. It started off higher, but then it quickly settled down to around 29, 30 watts. And then the temperature readout on the GPU started out around like 78-ish, so high 70s, and then kind of settled down to about 72. Sometimes it kind of hit about 71, so that's pretty standard. Let's go ahead and do another run just to make sure that these numbers are accurate and make sure that turbo is really burnt off. So let's go ahead and run it again. Okay, after the second result, we get the same 38 FPS. I was watching the power and the temperature, and for power, it was still hanging around 29, 30 watts. In temperature, same, about 71. In a couple spots, it actually got a little cooler to 70, but I'm gonna call it 71 on this with 30 watts of power, an average FPS of 38 with the stock paste. And I will note, I have all the latest drivers as of right now. I am in turbo mode, stock fan speeds, everything like that. So let's go ahead and switch over to a different testing scenario. So next up we have 3DMark Time Spy. I wanna run this because it actually does report clock speeds tracked on a graph. So I thought this one would be a good one to test with so we can see how the changes in paste or thermal solutions are gonna change clock speed variance. So let's go ahead and run this. It's gonna take a minute.
Wow, that's boosting high. 89C, 92, wow. All right, here are the results. We got a Time Spy score of 3,133. I will say that, man, this ally was boosting super high at the beginning run of this. I saw it as high as 47 watts and 92C. This thing was cranking, wow. It eventually settled down to about the same range as Horizon Zero Dawn. It was about 72C once it got to 30 watts. So yeah, what we can see with the chart down here that it's gonna show us the purple line is the CPU clock frequency. So let's see, that's about 1500 on these lower lines. And then it was boosting up to, God, what is that? That's it's like 5,700, 5,600, somewhere around there. And you can see, especially during the CPU test, we're sitting around that 4,000 line. Oh, okay, yeah, I can use this to show off. So it's in about 4,000. It gets a little bit lower. That's 38, 39. But yeah, at its peak, that was 49,000. And then for the GPU clocks, it was the highest at the beginning. The GPU clock frequency is 2600, and then over time it settled down to about 2300. So not too bad. Let's do another run just to make sure that these results are valid. So after the second run, we got just a teensy higher of a score at 3161. I did notice it actually maintained the boost a little bit longer in this second run. You can kind of see on that GPU clock, it's at 2.5, and even towards the end, it's about that stable 2.5 gigs. So that's actually a little bit better, because that first run, it kind of dipped down to about 2.3. And then even on the CPU side of things, it's just a little bit higher at 4.1 average is what I'm gonna say, maybe about 4.2. So the second run, it actually boosted a little bit better.
All right, so that was actually pretty helpful to see the actual clock frequencies in Time Spy. I'm glad I ran this instead of Cyberpunk. In the last video, some people actually noticed that the Cyberpunk result was not accurate the second time I ran it after the repaste. So the actual results were not accurate. So I actually prefer what we're gonna get out of Time Spy here. So now that I have some results with the stock thermal paste solution, let's go ahead and turn it off, crack it open, and put in some different solutions to see if we can get any better results on this ally. You know what I just noticed? This sticker on the back says, handheld console PC. Don't tell Gordon. Don't tell Gordon it says console on it. Then he won't be as excited anymore. Get in here. Here's some nice popping and cracking. That's when we know we're in. There we go. Get that screw out. You bugger. And we got the nice fresh insides. I will say the one change I did make to this before, I've cracked it open before, is that a 2 terabyte Sabrent Rocket. It is a really nice upgrade to the ROG Ally. I just wanted a little more space. Let's unplug the power. I can just do it like that. And then we need to unscrew, what was it? It was one, two, I think it was just, oh, yeah, need to take that off. Put that over here for safekeeping. We got 1, 2, 3, 4 on the fans, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 on the actual spreaders. Void my warranty, the sticker. Just kidding, doesn't void anything. Back it out slowly. Even pressure, as much as I can. All right, and it should be loose. So let's see, oh yeah, I need to undo the fan header once I peel it back. Oh, I'm stuck, there we go. Okay, you know what, actually I think I can probably just leave it like this, clean it like that. So this thermal paste application actually looks a little bit better than the review unit I had. So
let's go ahead and clean this up. Yeah, get all that excess off there. Nice and clean. Once again, Willis is good enough.
Good enough.
Good enough. Forget being a doctor. You don't want me on the assembly line. I'd be on the assembly line being like, ah, yeah, it's good enough.
Good enough.
You don't want to buy an ally for me where it's just, ah, good enough. Okay, that is squeaky clean. Let's try out the first thing I want to test, and this is the Thermo Grizzly Cryonaut. Tried and true, something I use on desktop CPUs all the time. I will mention it is not intended for this use case scenario because of the mounting pressure. It actually would burn off a little bit quicker and require repasting way more often in this situation. So I personally would actually not use this, but a lot of people mentioned it in the comments. So I'm gonna test it out anyway. I think that should be enough. I like to use a ton. I like to just real glob it on there. Now it's the art project time. Ooh yeah, just a little bit of happy trees. Just a little bit this way. Just a little bit that way. Oh yeah, cover side to side. Oh yeah, I'm getting it everywhere.
That's a lot.
Getting it real, real good. Luckily it's not conductive. I'm not gonna break anything. I always say it's better to have too much than not enough. That's a masterpiece, Willis. You know what I'm gonna say to that? It's good enough.
Good enough.
Let's go ahead and reverse the process of putting this back together. So I'm gonna drop. Ugh. No, actually, you know what? I need to put the fans under first. There we go. There we go. Now lower it gently onto that Z1. Apply a little bit of pressure. Apply the pressure. I didn't put the tape back on those fan wires, but it doesn't look like they're gonna get caught in the blades, so. Good enough. Now, let's put the back cover back on. Crunch.
What was Gordon's definition of a PC again? As long as they can do your taxes?
Do your taxes.
Yeah, so technically you can do your taxes, right?
You can 100% do your taxes on an ROG Ally.
So this Ally is...
But if Gordon saw that sticker and it said handheld console, it just says the word console. I think he can tell. He's like, hold up, this thing's a console. So yeah, before I show it to him, I should probably just peel the sticker off. It is back on, and you know what? I'm gonna peel this sticker off. I don't want Gordon to see this. So there we go. No mention of a console here. Let me make sure it doesn't. Nope, doesn't say anything there. All right. Now we have a different thermal solution. Let's go ahead and plug it in because I forgot to plug the battery back in. Great. Good enough. Good enough.
Good enough.
Jeez. One more time. There we go. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's what I forgot. That is not good enough. Now it's good enough. there we go. Second time's a charm, and I remember from the first time that I tore it down, you gotta plug it in before it'll turn on. Wait for the light. Oh, we see the light. And like that, it turns on. No butt puckering this time.
Adam, what's up? What happened?
Yeah, you know what? I forgot to put one more thing back in the Steam Deck, so yeah, I gotta open it up yet again. Wow, I must be tired. Oh, let's just turn this video off now. Well, that's where this goes, right here. Go back to your home, your little home. This it's just a little shield. Yeah, it would have been fine. It would have been fine. But you know what? That's not. Oh, you know what? It is how I do it around here. It's good enough. No, that's not good enough. I need to put all the pieces back in place for fair testing. Oh boy, did I forget anything else? Did I forget anything else?
Double check. I don't, sweeping the desk.
I don't think so.
We just need instead of a swear jar, we need like a good enough jar, just like on your desk. Just
yeah.
Like.
Every time I break something or forget something, yeah. Wow. Wow. All right. I'm getting real good at screwing these in. By the way, if you want to hire me just to screw stuff in, maybe that's worth it. Once again, oh no, I don't need to plug it in. Well, I need to plug it in anyway. So let's power it on and get into a benchmark. All right, we're back in Horizon Zero Dawn with the Cryonaut solution. Double check the settings. Once again, everything looks fine, original. And let's go ahead and run the benchmark. Okay, so we're done with the first run. Obviously, that 31 or 39 average is within margin of error. I'm not too concerned about that. Concerning the power, it actually maintained that 42, 43-ish watt boost through that whole first run. And temperature-wise, I actually never saw it go above 89. So it is actually staying a little bit cooler, and we got a slight increase. The fan noise, I'm not specifically measuring the fans, fan speeds, but the fan noise is seems to be a little quieter than before, but that's just, I'm not actually measuring it, so don't take that as word. Let's go ahead and do another run. I'll be curious to see how long it maintains the boost on this second run. So on the second run, it actually immediately started off pretty much at the 30 watts. It did not maintain that boost. For temperatures, it was hanging around 71, you know, maybe a 70 towards the end. So maybe just a little cooler than the stock, but once again, this is just a brand new application job. I have not put it through its paces. And I mean, the score is 39. It's the same. It's within margin of error. So I would say right now, under these conditions, it's performing pretty much the same as the stock, but that doesn't mean it's necessarily any better or the longevity is going to be there. So let's go ahead and back out of this and fire up TimeSpy. So now we're going to run TimeSpy. Very curious to see if we are going to see any differences in clock speeds, which we'll see at the end of this benchmark. That's boosting, baby. And that is not as high. Okay, so it did not maintain its boost through the whole run. About halfway through, it kind of burned it off and settled back down to that 30 watts, 72C range. The score, 31, 34, is pretty much similar to that first run that we did with the stock paste. It was a 3133. Let's look at the clock speeds. For the GPU, we're at 2.5. Settled down to around 2.3 over time as it burnt off that boost. Yeah, 2.3 I think would probably be an average. Oh, you know what, 2.6 is what it was calling at the beginning. For the CPU, a little bit lower, 3.8, 4.1. It looked like it had this little sharp spike back here at the end, but definitely did not boost as hard. But like we saw last time, the second run actually did a little bit better. So let's go ahead and run it for a second time. All right, so that second run with the Cryonaut got a little bit better of a score. I did notice that the boost was holding for just a little bit longer. Let's look at the clocks. GPU clock is highest 27, so a little bit better, and then it's lowest 2.3, and up here 2.6, 2.7. For the CPU, it did peak pretty high over here. What is that? That's 5 gig, and then it kind of settled down to 3.8, 3.9. Yeah, overall, it's not bad. It's performing about the same as stock. Giving what I know about Cryonaut,
and the solution on here, even though it's working about the same as stock, I don't think that's worth it.
So after a couple tests, I don't think Cryonaut is the way to go. Personally, obviously there could be more testing to be done. We would have to see how it would hold up over time, but I don't think it would be worth it. So let's switch over to another option, which I talked about earlier, which is that PTM 7950. It's a thermal pad, and we're gonna crack it open once more and switch over to that. Let's see if I can take this apart and put it back together without screwing up this time. How about that? That would be fun. That's a good idea. That's novel. Click, click. Carefully peel this off and see the mess I made. Okay. Okay, yeah. Well, I made a mess.
Not bad.
Not bad. Not bad. But let's clean it up. Luckily, because it is pretty much brand new paste. Oh yeah, that stuff's, and it's thinner. It's just wiping right off. All right, so now let's apply the PTM 750 I have here. Now I have seen a lot of chatter online that the ROG Ally's stock thermal solution could actually be this, or maybe some variation of this. So this is actually not a thermal paste. This is a phase change TIM, or thermal interface material. So it actually works differently than a paste would, which is once again why I probably wouldn't go with the Cryonaut in this situation. So either the Ally uses something exactly like this, so we're not gonna see that much of a benefit, or because I'm using pretty much the same thing but putting on a fresh one, maybe I will see a little bit of a benefit. So I'm kind of curious. But first things first, I need to cut it down to size because obviously the Z1 Extreme is not this big. So I'm gonna have to kind of measure it out and cut it. Luckily, it is not conductive. So just like thermal paste, I'm not gonna have to worry about spillover. So I'm probably gonna cut it a little bit wider than I need to. So let's go ahead and open it up. So there's a little thin piece of film on both sides. I'm actually not touching the TIM right now. This makes it easier to kind of handle for now and while I'm cutting. So I need to kind of line it up. I'm gonna use this corner as a guide. Once again, I'm gonna do a little bit extra. I'm gonna get somewhere to generally mark it. Once again, I'm gonna cut a little wider than I actually need. I will point out, luckily, This pad that I got is much larger, so I can mess up a couple times. Not that I do, not that I will, but you know, maybe. You never know. You never know around here. Okay, so far so good. All right, there we go. A clean cut. I'm just gonna lay this on right there just to kinda eyeball it, so it's a little wide that way, it's a little wide this way. Probably didn't need to cut it that wide, but good enough. Good enough. In this case, it's good enough on the side of caution. I will take that. So now I have to carefully peel back the film that is on both sides so that I can apply it. First I need to pick it up. There we go. They include in this little packet, I will say they include things that I'm supposed to use, like little finger cots. Should I put the finger cots on? Would that be funny?
Yes.
All right. Well then, here we go. I forgot to use the most important part, little finger cots. No jokes here, please. No jokes.
Keep it PG. You still need that Disney sponsorship.
You know what? I'm gonna be honest. I actually don't know what this little brush is for, and I don't need a screwdriver. I've already got plenty of that.
It was a little bit of like to do some glazing with the brush.
Yeah. Oh, some alcohol disinfectant wipes. Yeah. This is probably just to clean it off. Yeah. I got my own stuff. A little nice plastic spudger, and then it's got these things that'll help me hopefully peel the film off. So you're gonna see me struggle with this. Hopefully this is comical for somebody. Oh, look at that. It's working.
Oh.
There it is. Okay, I at least got one side off. So I'm gonna go ahead and I guess I'll just put that in here. I've made a mess. All right, let's go ahead and see if I can carefully apply it. Is that covering? Yeah, looks like it's covering. Oh, you know what? Maybe that's what this brush is for? I don't. Somebody in the comments is gonna tell me, no, you were supposed to use the brush like this. Actually, I just feel fancy using the brush. All right, can we get the sticker or the film off? Nope.
Aye.
Once again, do not hire me on a factory line. Oh my goodness, all right, let me try this again. There we go, huh? Huh? Oh, but that corner is old. Oh my. Oh yeah, that's... Oh my. That's perfect. That is perfect.
Not a good enough scenario? Just perfect, huh? This is...
Yeah, this is better than good enough, Willis. What are you talking about? Do you not like this? That is perfection. Look at that.
I like to get Gordon's opinion on this.
It's good enough. Yeah, I'm gonna call that good enough. Hopefully I'm just supposed to put one layer on it. Now I'm wondering if I need to put two, but no, I think it's just one. No, yeah. Yeah, okay, yeah, good enough. Whatever, let's try it. Let's put it back together. I didn't even need these finger cots. I feel cool. It's like, pew. The little finger guns, little protected finger guns. All right, so. And twist. All right, I'm gonna remember this. Little shieldy shield. There we go, plug the battery back in. Am I missing anything?
Double check.
Boom. I think I'm good. Let's go put the, wait. Yes. Okay, look at that. I think I put everything back together the correct way. Let's plug it in. Yep, the battery's attached. And let's power it on. Oh, you know what? I realized I can't log in with this finger cot. So
can you maybe try?
Yeah.
Can you
sure? Oh, try. All right, man. Ooh, that'd be a bad look if I could. Yeah, because I don't think it's gonna be able to read my fingerprint. Nope. It's like no, don't do that. There we go. That worked. I'll just keep my glove, or my thumb. All right, well, I'll boot it back up. Let's open up Afterburner, and let's fire up Horizon Zero Dawn. Okay, we're gonna go into settings, double check everything's right, and run the benchmark. It's got a good boost going. It's not warming up too bad yet. Okay, so after that first run, got an average FPS of 39. It was boosting to pretty much 42, 43 watts. And the temperature, it started off like 84-ish C, and then kind of climbed a little bit to 87. So I never saw it go over 90. But once again, we need to do another run, make sure it warms up real nice, and we'll see how it does after this. Okay, after that second run, we get the same 39 FPS average, but I did notice about a quarter of the way into the run, the boost started to burn off, and about halfway, it had settled down to about that 29, 30 watts like we saw before, and about 71, 72-ish C. So pretty much like what we've seen with the other solutions, but let's switch over to Time Spy. After that first run, we are still not able to beat the 3161 average that we got with the stock paste. And if we go over here, the GPU clock's about, what is that, 2.7, and then it settled down to around 2.3. CPU clock's under the stress test. Looks like the highest was like 47, or a 4.7, and then it settled down to 4.5, then 3.8 down here, 3.9. So, yeah, about the same. Let's do another run. Okay, so after that second run, the journey was quite similar. It boosted, it maintained the boost till about halfway through the run. We get a little bit better of a score. GPU clock said, what is that? That's 27, so 2.7. Down here, it's about 2.3, 2.4. CPU clocks under the CPU load. And what is that, 4.5. Lowest is about 3.8. So not too bad, but once again, not the high score we got with the actual stock.
So wrapping up, obviously the question at the end here is it worth it? I don't know, but between what I did in the last video with the Thermalright TF7, the Thermal Grizzly Cryonaut, the PTM 7950, unfortunately, I'm not seeing any great gains. I mean, obviously, I need to kind of continue to use this and maybe see if I'm seeing something after repeated warm up and cool down cycles. But you know, I was hoping, like we've seen with the Steam Deck, that you apply some new thermal paste and man, you get this big drop in temperatures. But I'm just not seeing it here. I'm personally not seeing it. Maybe others have. If you're getting better temperatures, please let me know what you did and how you're doing it with the stock settings. I know I can go in there and change the fan curves, and there's definitely utilities to kind of manage boost better, things like that. But I just wanted to see, just with the stock configuration, would applying a different kind of thermal solution help? And I'm underwhelmed. I'm not excited. And at this point, I don't know. I mean, apart from liquid metal, which I'm not gonna do, I don't think that there's gonna be any sort of benefit to reapplying a new thermal material, unless it's obviously you've been using it for a while and you're gonna see some degradation. So anyway, long story short, no, I don't think it's worth it. If you have, please let me know in the comments. If you want me to test it a different way, I might try it. Let me know. Yeah, if you like this sort of dumb fun testing, then be sure to subscribe here on PC World for more PC hardware and software goodness. Until next time, we'll see you later.